everybody. I'm Steve Zabriskie along with John Spagnola. Gary Reasons will join us from the sidelines as well. As far as Oregon State University is concerned, this is their bowl game. This is the Civil War. And one of the things that makes a game such as this so interesting, John, is how well these two teams know each other.
Well, that's right. They're located only 31 miles apart, but they might as well be worlds apart in the way they move the football offensively. Danny O'Neill leads this potent duck attack. It's a well-balanced offense, and they have surged into overdrive in recent weeks. Last week alone, he passed for a school record 6 touchdown passes, but he's going to go against a difficult Beaver defense that likes to blitz with impunity. They will cause him a lot of problems. On the other side of the football, you have 2 quarterbacks who run like halfbacks, and they're going to direct this ground-oriented attack. Don Shankle will get the start. He's coming off a broken nose last week against Washington State. He'll be spelled by Raheem Mohammed, who's a quick-footed little guy. He comes in and he ignites this football team with his running ability. Here's the key matchup of this football game, though, and that is the Beaver rushing attack, which nobody's been able to stop this year. 3rd in the NCAA at 285 a game. They're going against the number 11 rushing defense in the country. Therein lies the key matchup.
Oregon State won the toss. They, however, have elected to defer to the second half, and so Oregon will take the ball to begin the game. The Beavers huddling. Brooke Knight, number 14, a senior from here in Corvallis, does the kicking off for the Beavers. Herman O'Berry, number 4, to the right. Number 14, Ricky Whittle, to the left, back deep for the Ducks. Herman O'Berry at about the 2. To the 22. Knocked down by Chris Royal, number 29.
The Ducks get another chance to convert this first down.
They're at the 19 of Oregon State. Play action. O'Neill to Philgall, wide open. Touchdown, Oregon. Well designed and well executed for the first score of the game as O'Neill fakes twice in the backfield, and one of those guys, Dino Filial, gets loose for the touchdown.
Well, and if you give a good football team a second chance, they're going to make you pay for it every time. Misdirection play, and Filial out in the flat for the easy touchdown for the Ducks.
Matt Belden on for the extra point. Backup quarterback Ryan Perry Smith is the holder. And it is good. 7:21 left in the first quarter. The Oregon Ducks trying to make it to Pasadena have a leg up with the first score of the game, 7-0. Matt Belden will have to punt out of his own end zone. William Ephraim is back around the 45 of Oregon. Under pressure, and it's blocked in the end zone. Who's got it?
It's either going to be a safety or a touchdown.
The officials are trying to figure it out.
Larry Bumpus got the block.
Touchdown, Oregon State. Larry Bumpus has had a tremendous second half of the season on special teams as he blocks this punt in the end zone.
Watch number 2 at the top of the screen coming off the left side, untouched. Larry Bumpus, who came here as a quarterback, gets right to the block point, picks that ball off with his right hand, makes the block, and Oregon State recovers in the end zone. Steve, this is the 3rd year in a row. You can see right as he goes to the block point with his right hand, takes that thing right off the punter's foot, and Oregon State recovers.
Very hard to see who got it. Now, an extra point attempt. Upright and is no good. Randy Lund, who had made 20 of 25, bangs it off the upright, and Oregon still leads by 1. And the wind will be blowing mostly from behind Belden. He hits it well, and it's right through there. And Oregon extends their lead to 10-6. With just a 1:10 remaining, let's get a report from the sidelines and Gary Reasons before halftime.
Steve, as we talk at the top of the telecast, we got a packed house here. This crowd is really into the ball game. The Beavers and the Duck fans are all on their feet. The rain, the cold weather, nothing is dampening their spirit. It's a good close ball game, and the fans are really enjoying this one. Steve?
I imagine, Gary, you can really feel the intensity, much more so down there than we can up here. We hear the noise, but they're just going nonstop a time well before the kickoff, really.
A lot of people don't realize this is the longest series in the West Coast, 98th game they're playing here today. A lot of people look at the game, Cal and Stanford, they're only playing their ninth, not only, but it's their 97th game here today. Of course, that started before this one did in 1894. But,
this is the 100th anniversary of the Civil War here in Oregon.
There's about 115,000 graduates of Oregon and Oregon State who still live in this state, and I think that's why you get the named the Civil War, which has also been called the War of the Roses this week, and there's been all sorts of names put on this football game.
The ball about a foot away from the goal line. Oregon leading Oregon State by four. And Schmidtman takes it in for the touchdown.
Defense and an impressive drive by Oregon State after stopping Oregon on fourth down.
Doesn't hurt that Fengus 305 pounds either. Randy Lund on for the extra point attempt. Close, it's good. Boy. Got it inside the right upright. And Oregon State has taken a 13-10 lead here in the third quarter.
Doug Stuckey with his second shank of this game, but when you have four guys breaking through on your foot, you start to speed up your rate at which. Look at the pressure from all around him, and that's what caused the ball to come off the side of his foot and result in such a short punt.
Oregon, down by three, has the football, and O'Neal will run. O'Neal with a first down into Oregon State territory at the 26. Rico Petrini finally got him out of bounds. And that's something that Danny O'Neal does very well, but until that play, we really haven't seen. He goes for 21 yards.
Now, the way he's been banged up with his ankle, I didn't expect him to hurt this defense. Running the football, it's play action pass. Again, the pressure's there. That means people are locked into man coverage, though. He outruns Kane Rogers, 17, gets down the sideline and makes a big play. The Ducks enjoyed a good field position from the four punt there, and they're taking advantage of that on a big play by O'Neal, trying to get some going here offensively.
From the 26, Hillyard running hard. Three passes for 133 yards. A big third down for the Ducks. O'Neal against the blitz, and McLemore has it for a first down at the 14. Again, Reggie Tong with the coverage.
Great execution up front. O'Neal had to throw the football while McLemore broke into the open. He had to hold the long ball a pretty long time in the face of a blitz. Watch how everybody picks up their assignments. At the very end, 34, Dwayne Jones picks up his man, and that allows O'Neal to deliver a strike to McLemore.
The ball back to the 19, where it is first and 15 for Oregon. Filial in motion. O'Neal against the butts to Filial. Filial has a block! Touchdown, Oregon!
Dino Filial with his second touchdown reception of the day. Earlier it was on a bootleg, this time it's on a screen. He starts out in motion, goes to his right side. He's got blockers in front. It's a quick screen. He came back in the middle. Excellent blocking up front. A terrific call by Mike Bellotti and flawless execution by the Ducks.
Matt Belden on to attempt the extra point. And it's a big one because it's a 3-point lead right now. And he knuckleballs it through there for a four-point Oregon advantage at 17-13, 3:37 to go. Filia, look at the blocking in the hole as Dino puts Oregon on top.
It all comes down to this fourth down play.
I don't know where Shanklin hurt his thumb or whether it's just cold, but he's got it in his mouth. 41 seconds left on the clock, but more importantly, it is fourth down and seven for the Beavers, who are 2 of 4 on fourth down conversions today.
How fitting it all comes down to this in the Civil War.
Shanklin to throw again. Under pressure, incomplete. Intended for Joe Douglas at the goal line, and Oregon will take over on down. There is a penalty flag down on the far sideline.
There's several flags on the side, on the far sideline. There's several flags on the field.
Well,
Kenny
Oregon
Wheaton on coverage.
Oregon may be a flag here for celebrating.
That's a pretty quick flag. If it came out that quick, I think there might be some bumping around, interference offensively or defensively. Keep in mind, Kenny Wheaton was that hero of the Washington game. He had an interception for a touchdown as Washington was driving to go ahead late in that football game. By the way, Aliotti and company are celebrating on the sidelines. They must feel that the penalty is against Oregon State.
The officials are still huddling. And let's see what Chuck McFerrin can tell us.
The pass was incomplete. There was a dead ball. Personal foul on the defense. 15 yards. First and 10.
State and no timeouts remaining.
And the roses are out here for the Ducks. It's been 37 years since they've won the Pac-10 and been able to go to the Rose Bowl. Back then it was the Pacific Coast Conference.
O'Neal takes a knee. They'll either have to take a penalty or run one more play, as there will be a few seconds remaining. Brooks has been hoisted on the shoulders of his players, and he will be carried triumphantly onto the field as Oregon will allow time to run out, and they will go back to the Rose Bowl for the first time since the end of the 1957 season. They will also have won 9 games since the first time since 1948.
And they'll play Penn State, the Big Ten champion, ranked 2nd in the country in the Rose Bowl.
Here's the 1957 team that played in the 58 Rose Bowl. These guys will be joined by these guys. And what a year for Rich Brooks. We talked about the adversity, the 1-2 start, and Gary Reasons is on the field with Coach Brooks right now. Gary?
Steve, we've got Coach Brooks, you've got to be very excited. A chance to win a big ball game here. Your thoughts on the game and going to the Rose Bowl?
Well, we're just excited to be going to the Rose Bowl. It's just a terrific thing. That drive by Danny O'Neal and Kristen McLemore and the pass to Dino Filia was just perfect. It was a drive that we had to have in a game that was obviously a real tough defensive struggle.
You had a slow start. Things weren't going good. To come back, your kids had a lot of heart all year. What do you think about your team?
Well, this team deserves to be in the Rose Bowl. They've made all the plays they needed to make all year long.
Coach, you had a great effort. Congratulations. Steve?
You guys better get out of there before you can't get out of there. Let's go back and take a look at the winning touchdown as O'Neal hit Filia for the score. And this was a gutsy drive when they really had to have it.
Yes, it was. They weren't playing well up to here. Filia had gone in motion, came back inside on the quick screen. That's his second touchdown reception of the day. And that's the one that puts these Ducks into the Rose Bowl.
Well, and our Chevrolet, genuine Chevrolet, most valuable players of the game are Kristen McLemore for Oregon, who had 4 catches for 73 yards, 3 of them in that big touchdown drive in the fourth quarter, and J.D. Stewart, the fullback for Oregon State, who carried 18 times for 64 yards, and a lot of them were big key yards for Oregon State. It turned out to be everything we thought it would be, and Oregon will represent the Pac-10 of the Rose Bowl.
And how ironic is it that Danny O'Neill chose not to go to USC to come to Oregon so he could play 4 years, and here he is edging out USC and going to the Rose Bowl with his Oregon football team.